Well, it's been about 3 weeks since we put the low tunnel hoops in, and we got the row cover and the greenhouse plastic over on top of them. However, we did not get a chance to actually secure the hoops down the way that I wanted to. The night that we put it in, the bottom dropped out on the temperature. It's been cold. We had this cold snap in the middle of November. But then on the warm days, when it would warm up above freezing, it would be really windy. And I didn't feel like wrestling around with like 20 feet of plastic on days like that. On the warm days though, we would open up and vent the low tunnel, and we would allow the excess heat to drain out. But we've been harvesting, we've been using the low tunnel, and we've gotten some really good results and success from it. But today, it's warmed up, the wind is pretty moderate and light. I wanna take the plastic off, the row cover off, and I want to show you what I wanted to originally do with the hoops and securing them down with rope and some stakes, and then also how we fasten the plastic onto the hoops and then keep the sides weighed down. So let's check that out. The first thing after uncovering the low tunnel, what I'm gonna do is I have my stakes, which I have, these are just wooden stakes. I've drilled a nice little hole through them, about a 3/4 inch hole. And I am going to put one stake at this end and one at the other end. This is what's gonna anchor our rope that's gonna secure the low tunnel frame or the hoops. There's folks I've seen use rebar, and I think that works fine. The one thing I've heard though is that when the soil gets wet in the winter and early spring, rebar tends to be pulled through the soil because it moves much easier than say a flat piece of wood like this. So I'd say use whatever you have that's available. We have a bunch of wooden stakes, that's why I'm using that. But you want to drive it in at an angle because there's going to be a lot of pulling happening when the wind is hitting the plastic on this high tunnel, and or when there's a snow load on top. So it's going to be pulling on these stakes. And so this is going to be the thing that's going to keep this tunnel up, hopefully, fingers crossed, you know, when the snows arrive and the cold winter winds start whipping down through here. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to take our rope and we are going to tie one end at the stake on one side of the low tunnel, and then we will wrap the rope around the center of the low tunnel frames or the hoops, and we'll just pretty much create a spine all along the center, and we'll tie it off at the other end of the low tunnel. Next, we're going to put the row cover back on, and then the polyplastic, we're going to secure it with these plastic clips. The way that I like to do this, and it's especially helpful even on like a windy day or really any time, is to pretty much secure one side of the plastic, one end of the plastic, and then come to the opposite end and then pull it really tight and then secure that end. I actually don't clip the hoops in the middle unless they're, you know, the plastic's really loose or something like that. But I fasten it to the hoop on one end, stretch the row cover and plastic to the opposite end, and then pull as hard as I can, and then clip the plastic to the end hoops. So let me show you how I do that. When it comes to the row cover and even the polyplastic, they do have cues of where the middle of the material is. And so here, it's actually the name of the product. They have it running right down the middle, and so that's what you want to line up in the center. So this is one end, I put the row cover over. I'm gonna fasten this end and then go to the opposite end, pull real hard, fasten that end. And then that's the row cover, next will be the plastic. And now we have the plastic. So what I'm gonna do, got the row cover nice and tight over here. Plastic's just going right over top. It's gonna give us that dual layer of insulation. That's gonna be really helpful in keeping a lot of heat trapped in here on those cold days. With the plastic, you're going to look for where the folds are in the material. And there's different folds, but you can find the center fold here, and you wanna make sure you keep that online right down the middle of your low tunnel frames right here. So these white row cover or plastic clips, they really only work best if you put them on like a straight run of pipe. Don't put them on the curved part because you're not going to get a very secure grip. So once you get your ends clipped together of your row cover or your plastic, you can pretty much, you can go from end to end, undo the clips, tighten things up if you need to. But after you get the plastic secure to the frame, next is securing the edges. Where I'm located, we get a lot of wind. 30 mile per hour gusts are pretty much business as usual where I'm located. So we do have to take a bit of extra effort to secure down the edges, just because I don't want to be driving down the highway one day and see a sail of plastic from my low tunnel blowing across the road. What we're using to secure our edges is concrete block, really heavy block, and that's not the ideal material to use, mostly because of these sharp corners here. As the plastic moves in the wind, the corners of the blocks do rip and tear holes in the fabrics and the plastic. So I really do recommend, you know, if you can, this is material we have, but if you can, use some type of like bags that are built for this. You fill the bags with rock. Don't fill them with soil or anything. What folks have found out is if you fill the bags, the weighted bags, with soil, is they'll dry out over the winter and they get really light. And then, you know, the heavy bags that you started off with the fall, by springtime, they're not heavy enough to hold down the plastic. So I recommend something that without sharp corners or edges that would be poking holes in your plastic, because the goal is to keep your low tunnel plastic going for years and years. You know, the life expectancy for a lot of greenhouse or high tunnel, low tunnel plastic is about 7 years. And you want to make sure that it survives that long to meet that life expectancy. What I do for the ends of the low tunnel, I actually will gather them up and I will roll them like I'm rolling up like the ends of a Tootsie Roll, a piece of candy. And then I'll just lay that on the ground, put a big old heavy concrete block on top of that. I'll do that for either end. Very useful, very easy to take that off, unroll it, look underneath the plastic, make sure everything's doing all right underneath. So that is building a low tunnel. Took a little bit longer than I had hoped, but hopefully you enjoyed this video. Please like our channel, subscribe, and as always, thank you all for watching.